The Arizona Department of Transportation sponsors an Adopt a Highway program that lets individuals, organizations, and businesses adopt a 2-mile stretch of highway from which they promise to remove litter at least 3 to 4 times a year. But a Verde Valley man says the volunteer program isn't getting the job done. Vietnam veteran Gary Chamberlain is tired of the trash, and he's recruiting folks to help him get rid of it, even if it means stepping on the toes of ADOT and existing Adopt a Highway volunteers. I recently spoke with Chamberlain about his plans to start a movement he refers to as Folksville USA. Thank you for joining us tonight on Arizona Horizon.
I'm tickled to be here.
Good. That's good to hear. I want to find out what got you started with all this, picking up trash, cleaning highways in Arizona.
I moved to Cornville, Arizona. And I'm a cyclist, and two of us who are cyclists rode our bike from Cottonwood to Sedona, and we were disgusted with the amount of trash we saw on the highway. It was so bad that we knew we had to make steps or take steps to try to improve this situation. And what we tried to do was to get the Adopt a Highway groups who have their names on the signs to actually honor their commitment to the Adopt a Highway program, which you may or may not know is 3 times a year or more, and the or more applies to a scenic highway. And it's been a battle for about 4 years, but 3 years ago we hit a high mark when on November 11th we had over 300 people out on 30 miles of highway between Cottonwood and Camp Verde and Cottonwood, Sedona, and picked up 404 bags of trash, not to include 2 mattresses, and that was huge. That showed that the groups were coming together and recognizing that working as a team, things work better.
So are you working with the Adopt a Highway program? Or are you working separate and apart from that? How does this work?
Well, as a citizen and as an Adopt a Highway participant, because myself and another person who started this 4 years ago, we have adopted 2 miles, one on Highway 260 and 89A. We work the two in tandem. We're kind of out of the box in many ways. We conform to the Adopt a Highway rules in many respects. And in other respects, we're trying to get ADOT to employ some techniques that we're looking at that are different if we can get them to rewrite their regulations.
What kind of techniques?
Well, such as not allowing someone who has a 1-mile section adopted not to be able to clean somebody else's section. Can you imagine cleaning up your 1-mile section where it's spotless, honoring your commitment, and being on either side of somebody who doesn't? And ADOT does not allow that.
Why?
You would have to, it violates their regulations.
Okay.
The other thing is they ask is that you give a 5-day notice when you're going to go pick up. In this day and age, how many people who are volunteers know what they're doing 5 days from now? So another improvement to the program would be to allow people to go out and pick up just whenever they get the opportunity. That would really make it at their convenience, their volunteers, to go pick up when they want.
This I understand that there is some sort of like a $10 per bag of trash effort that you're involved with as well. What does that all mean? And is what you're doing volunteer work, or is it a for-profit venture?
In this case, it's for-profit. A Camp Verde Bugle did a story on me. I am running a for-profit, have a profit and loss income statement. I went to the local businesses after doing what I've been doing for 3 years to try to get these Adopt a Highway groups to join in the team concept, and I said, will you pay me personally for every $10, every bag of trash I go pick up on the highway? I was given $2,000 in about 3 days. About 3 months later, I went back to this different businesses and got another $2,000. I have picked up by myself over 400 bags of trash at $10 a bag, and we're doing this, as per the story in the Camp Verde Bugle, to try to get the kids to come out and use this as a fundraiser so they put me out of business so I can be more like the Maytag repairman.
But if you're doing something that ADOT kind of keeps a close eye on, has its regulations, as you said, shouldn't you be working with ADOT as opposed to maybe ADOT having these kinds of concerns regarding your group?
No, ADOT should have no concern, because here's the fact. You can ride your bike and you can run down any of these highways, okay? As an individual, you should be able to reach over and pick up a piece of trash and put it in a bag. And if some business wants to pay you to do that because you're making their community look good, ADOT has not given me 1 ounce of reason why I can't do that. And I will push that till the end.
Okay, it sounds like ADOT does have some concerns regarding safety of folks being on the side of the highway, especially when they're not aware of those folks being on the side of the highway, and safety in the medians as well. I know it's a big thing with you is getting those medians clean, but ADOT says that's a safety hazard.
Well, first of all, the people who are out there doing the group efforts, that is all done per the letter to the Adopt a Highway program. They're cleaning the shoulder. Long before I ever got involved in this, people 50 and over were cleaning the medians because, I got to tell you, they don't believe in doing a, you know, halfway job. Mm-hmm. There's another word for that, and you know what it is. It's the body part. So if ADOT is not going to clean those medians, these other groups who are volunteers, they're going to go clean them. That's how they were raised.
Well, that's how they were raised. But you understand ADOT's concern, especially if children are involved, regarding medians in highways. There is a safety factor there, and the state doesn't want to be liable for those folks.
Most of the people that you're calling children are probably 40-plus year old. There's a group of women who are part of the Adopt-a-Highway program in Cottonwood who take their kids out on the days they clean up, and when they're done with that, they go clean from the sidewalk off into the brush in the city of Cottonwood.
But kids are involved, and you are trying to recruit kids.
No, recruiting kids. Kids, if you call kids 12 and over, that's what we're recruiting. That's what the ADOT rules are. 12 and over to be part of the Adopt-a-Highway program.
You call your group Folksville USA. What's that all about?
Well, those of us who got involved in this thing became very frustrated with ADOT's even willingness to work with ideas and thoughts. I mean, just it was not workable. So we said, let's come up with our own name for a virtual town. And we chose Folksville USA because we thought that if it could take off and not only reach statewide attention, it could go national to get people to be involved in something that they coined their own phrase to get involved.
Judging from what I've seen, some of the paper, there's stories up there and some of the comments, it sounds like you're rankling a lot of folks up there.
Oh, yeah.
You're getting under their skin.
Good.
Because you're doing a my way, or if I dare to say, the highway kind of an approach. Is there a better way to work with others, or is this the way it's got to be?
Look, I've asked the director of ADOT, through his secretary, whose name is Mary, to sit down and have a meeting as much as 3 years ago. We have never been responded to. Now, the feathers being wrangled are those people who have their names on the signs who aren't honoring their commitment. We have 30 groups now who are 90% honoring their commitment. ADOT couldn't achieve this. We, as taxpayers, pay ADOT employees to manage a program that they can't seem to manage. And, you know, you bring these points up. I think the mature thing would be for the director of ADOT, not one of the people he throws to be a barrier in the progress of helping the state, to sit down and meet with us.
So I guess my last question for you would be,
sure,
who decided that you would be the one to make sure others, and even governmental agencies I can even understand, but others honor their commitment?
Well, I'm a taxpayer.
Mm-hmm.
You're a taxpayer. And if ADOT isn't going to see that these groups honor their commitment to the program, then who is? And so the group of us who started Folksville USA, because I'm outspoken and very passionate about this, said, you be the voice for us, we're behind you. And let me just say this.
Yes.
Of the $4,000 that's been donated to me, you don't think those 100 businesses or so are behind this thing? Maybe those are the people you should be going to ask, you know. By the way, the media, can I just touch on that for a second?
Quickly.
Yeah. I have asked ADOT to authorize me personally, just me, this individual, to go clean those medians. I said I will sign a release of waiver. They won't do it. And I will go clean those medians.
Well, I certainly hope that you and ADOT can get together, and you and the other groups that are cleaning the road highways up there can all get together, and maybe we can temper all of our messages and keep Arizona beautiful. Thank you so much for joining us.
One last thing on that.
Yes.
All those other groups,
yes.
I don't tell them to go clean the medians.
Mm-hmm.
They were doing it long before I came along.
Okay.
So ADOT needs to take that up with them, not
all
me.
Right. Good to have you here.
Thank you.